Hello, I'm Suman Agarwal. I'm the Senior Most Image Consultant in the Indian subcontinent. And today I'm going to share some interesting insights about image consulting as a profession. So just before we begin, I would also like to share that we've received some very interesting questions. And I'm going to address those questions one by one. So we've received this question from Kasturi Naidu. What is the scope of an image consultant in the current market? So before I give the answer of this question, I would like to give you a little bit of a brief. So when we look at image consulting as a profession, I would like to relate it with the medical profession. So just like in the medical profession, you have basically the doctors and the patients. So each and every person has to participate in the industry, either as a provider, that is a doctor, or as a seeker, as a patient. So when I compare this with the image consulting industry, each one of us will eventually have to participate in the industry, either as a provider, that is an image consultant, or as a seeker, that is the client. So when we talk about scope for an image consultant in the current market, before I tell you the scope, let us also understand what is or who is an image consultant. So image consultant is a person who helps you to manage the way you look, the way you carry yourself, the way you project in front of others. So managing your image, which is also your impression. So managing your impressions, that how people perceive you, how people think about you, is the job of an image consultant. So when we look at an image consultant, a person who helps you project a particular image based on your roles, goals, and occasion, that is the job that an image consultant does. So the person who is an image consultant also trains you on life skill. So when we look at the scope of image consulting in the Indian market, or I would say the current market, I would say that the scope is tremendous, because each and every person who is trying to climb the ladder of success needs skills on appearance management and, of course, soft skills. So a combination of these two is something that an image consultant works upon. Just like you have a personal trainer in the gym, very soon people will also realize that they need a personal image coach who can work on their appearance, their behavior, their communication, and of course the digital footprint. So these are the four important aspects on which an image consultant trains an individual or a group. So let us take these four elements step by step. So when we talk about appearance, it comprises of the four A's. The four A's are appropriate, authentic, attractive, and affordable. So an image consultant helps you to project an image which is appropriate to your roles, goals, and occasions. Authentic, which means the real you and not a fake image. Attractive, so that you feel confident and people notice you. And affordable, so which means that an image doesn't come expensive. You can manage an image which can be affordable. When we look at behavior, it reflects that how do you come across in front of the other person. So your body language and, of course, your etiquette. Talking about communication, we are talking about your vocal communication, your verbal communication. How do you channelize your thoughts in front of the other person, which is extremely important because it is not about what you speak, but how you speak. And of course, when we talk about your digital footprint, which is your social media presence, which is extremely important these days. Most people don't meet you in person, but they form a particular image about you through your social media presence. So how do you align your social media image vis-a-vis your actual image is something that your image consultant will help you form that particular kind of an image. So when you're looking at the current market and we are talking about the trends, each and every individual today is looking for a competitive edge. And to achieve that, They need an image consultant who can work with them through and through to manage their image in their personal, professional, and social life. So I hope I'm able to address the first question very, very clearly. Now, the second question is, what is the basic qualification a candidate should have for opting for the course? And this question has come from Dolly Malik. So Dolly, you'll be very happy to know that you don't need a specific academic qualification, because here we are looking at somebody who's able to communicate well and articulate their thoughts in a very clear manner. So as long as you have these two qualities, you're all set to become an image consultant. Looking at the third question, which has come from Stephanie Zhou, what are the courses you people provide and what is it all about? How do we get more details? So Stephanie, I would request you if you could go on to our website, which is imageconsultinginstitute.com, or you can also simultaneously, in fact, you can also log on to our ICBI Facebook page, which will have a lot of insights on what kind of work our image consultants do. And of course, while you're seeing this session live with me, you will also get a lot of many more opportunities to see such sessions in the future and to get more clarity about what exactly we do. Another question is that what are the opportunities after this course for an individual? So this question has come from Anisha Chaudhary. So looking at opportunities after doing an image consulting program, I would say that the opportunities are vast. Because when we look at image consulting as a profession, I would say that image consulting is just like an umbrella. So as long as there are people around, and any industry or any organization where you have people, so this is a very people-centric profession. So wherever you have people who are a part of any particular organization, you can source business there. So just to give you an example, you can work with a bank, you can work with an MNC, you can work with any organization, either as a trader or as an image auditor or as a uniform designer or in general just to provide corporate training services. And there are many more different levels of engagement for a corporate. When it comes to an individual engagement, again, the opportunities are vast, because sometimes you get an opportunity to work with children. Sometimes you're working with an individual who is looking for a job. You help them get the right kind of job based on their appearance. You work on their appearance, you work on their confidence level. Then sometimes you're working with somebody who's already a very senior professional in the industry to give another level of confidence so that they are able to achieve promotions, or they're looking for another job. You also work with different kind of people. So at times you are getting into, depending upon your areas of interest, you can be a stylist. You can also be, a facilitator mode. You know, when you are associated with any kind of an institute, a management institute, where you train the students before their placement time. You can also work as a trainer with an international school or another kind of a co-education school, where you give dining etiquette coaching to children. So why I'm giving you these kind of examples is because most of our consultants are doing this kind of work in the industry. So sometimes they are associated with the schools, they get empaneled by the schools. They also get associated with these kind of institutions that I'm talking about. They also work independently and do a lot of their own corporate workshops and individual workshops, so that they are able to touch different segment of the market. So depending upon what is the need. So for example, a lot of our consultants also do workshops for pregnant women. So this is something which is absolutely unique, but yes, there is a need, and that is why such workshops also become very successful. So when we talk about different kinds of work that are there in the market, the opportunities are huge, because as much innovation you can bring into your own ideas, the industry, the market is so huge that you can come up with almost anything that comes under the purview of image consulting. So go about it. So as long as you are active, so this question has come from Bijal Shah. As long as you are actively involved into your business, so business does not happen automatically, as you know. As long as you are involved and you're absolutely active in pursuing image consulting, you will get business and you will get work. So you have to be absolutely active on social media. You have to be absolutely active in coming up with a lot of innovative ideas. Of course, I mean, ICBI supports you in every way, but as long as you are active, there is a lot of work in the market. Okay, so another question that is there, what is a better way to improve your image? Is it through workshops or by hiring an image consultant? So this has come from Shalu Nar. So Shalu, let me tell you that when you attend a workshop, you get a general information about specific topics that the workshop is all about. But when you want customized solutions, you need to hire an image consultant, because they work on specific areas and they help you improve on those specific areas so that you become confident. So the answer is that you need to hire an image consultant, and the solutions do not come by just attending a workshop for your own personal image consulting. Okay. So another question has come from Pink's Nathani. I want to get into image consulting business as a part-time for now. I want to know, how should I go about it? Okay, so the answer to this question is that yes, you can do this work on part-time basis. So image consulting is something which grows, in terms of business. It grows when you devote more time to it. You can start as a part-time profession as well, and you can definitely pursue it starting as a part-time and then gradually moving to a full-time business. So let me tell you that there are a lot of consultants with ICBI also who are currently working and also are pursuing image consulting business on a part-time basis. When we talk about revenues, let me get into the fact that when you are doing this on part-time basis, of course you make less amount of money as compared to somebody who's into full-time image consulting profession. So your earning potential will vary depending upon what kind of time you are spending. So if you are a part-timer in image consulting profession, then you make money accordingly. If you are a full-time image professional, then of course your earning potential will grow according to that. You can also check for, you can look into the question answer session on the ICBI page, and you'll get the solutions there. So I guess that is all for today, and I would like to thank all of you to be a part of this session. And for many more such sessions where I will be giving you a lot of answers to all the queries that you have, you can be a part of ICBI Facebook page, and you can also get a lot of other insights on what kind of work our image consultants do as professionals. And I would look forward to interacting with you much more next time. And we will have these kind of sessions frequently on Facebook page. So thank you and stay tuned for more interaction.